Hi everyone, it is me, Kat, back with another electrical engineering video for all of you. This time, I'm so happy to announce a partner with one of my favorites to bring this content straight to you. Who could it be? Who could it be? Got it? That's right, Texas Instruments. Fun fact, when I was first learning PCB design, my mentor told me something I remember to this day. He said,
"Whenever possible, go TI."
The quality of their products is amazing, the availability is too, but my favorite point, and my mentor's as well when he brought this up to me, the documentation. I mean, it is just incredible. They teach you everything you need to know, and then some, and then they give you context, and then they give you background, and then they also give you future things to look into. They give you examples, they give you advice, they give you pitfalls. I mean, what more could you want? As you can tell, this is such an important point for me, and I really could make a whole video just on this alone. Should I? On to today's topic. What is power density? Let's start with some quick definitions.
Power density is a measure of the amount of power of a device or circuit divided by the volume of said device.
Now, can we think of some areas where power density might be important? Power density is particularly important for supply and power circuit design. So if you said that, good job. And if you didn't, it's okay, just keep watching. Power density is generally associated with power supplies, power ICs, and any circuit generating power. This measure is also very necessary because of the constant industry pressure to do more with less. Now, of course, some designers may get away with not really paying it too much attention, but there are absolutely industries where that is not the case. Here are some industry examples. We have aerospace, where every gram and every function counts. And that's also the industry that I myself have my experience with. We have the automotive industry, especially with the current trend towards EVs. And of course, we have consumer electronics, where we have the constant pressure to do more with less. Okay, speaking of the automotive industry, our demo today is gonna go over the TPSI 2140Q1. This is a 1200 volt, 50 milliamp automotive isolated switch optimized for high voltage switching in measurement applications. And to check out its functionality, we will be using the TPSI 2140Q1 EVM, which is the evaluation module. By the way, evaluation modules are another thing that I absolutely recommend, because as brand new designers or students, how many times did we read the data sheet?
Read it again, read it again, read it 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 10 times.
And we still weren't sure that the functionality of our circuit and of that particular IC was gonna match what we were imagining for the design. With evaluation modules like these, we can play around with our IC, make sure we understand its functionality perfectly before it becomes a vital component of our design and we order, say, I don't know, 100? True story. Yeah. The evaluation modules user guide also comes with everything you might need to know, down to the schematic, BOM, and even the layout. This device allows the designer to reduce cost and improve reliability by replacing mechanical relays or optically isolated devices. Here are some cool ways we can improve power density that are also mentioned in our particular datasheet. We can improve power density by improving package thermal performance, and in the datasheet, we see that it says that it comes with an SOIC 11-pin package with wide pins for improved thermal performance. Another way to improve power density is to adopt innovative topologies and circuits. And in the datasheet, we can see the TPSI 2140Q1 uses TI's high reliability capacitive isolation technology in combination with internal back-to-back MOSFETs to form a completely integrated solution requiring no secondary side power supply.
One of our probes is going to go to ground, and we have to be careful not to touch anything else. There it is. And the other probe will be going to TP7, which is where we're going to be able to actually see our output. Right now, everything is off, so we're seeing zero. We're giving it a VDD of about 5 volts, so let's check that out. Perfect. Now, the input for the relay technically goes in right here, and then has to go through this resistor train. However, I will be skipping that because the voltage I'm going to be feeding it is really not that much. I'm gonna give it about the same, 5 volts. So I'm gonna be putting it in right there. And there it is. We've energized our relay. Now let's take that off. There we go.
Now let's do power density calculations for two similar devices and compare their functionality. Okay, so first let's pull maximum power from the datasheet on both sides.
It's important to keep in mind that this Pmax I'm referring to is straight from the datasheet and related to these specific test conditions.
Then let's also pull the volume from the datasheet. And finally, we have the power density calculation. So for the TPSI 2140, we have 0.151. And then for the TPSI 2072, we have 0.148.
As we can see here, both the TPSI 2140 and TPSI 2072 have very, very similar power density.
This one is a one channel and 1200 volt, 50 milliamps. And then this one is two channel, 600 volt, 50 milliamps.
Okay, awesome. Now let's also take a look at how much power can be consumed under stressful conditions for the TPSI 2140. During high voltage transient testing, the switch can consume up to 2 milliamps for 5 seconds. We also know that the average voltage is 1550 volts. That gives us 3.1 watts. Divide that by the volume and we get 15.1 milliwatts per millimeters cubed. That is 100 times the power density. That's amazing. And that is also what the wider pins package was designed for. All right, now it's your turn. Feel free to do the same calculation for the TPSI 2072. Just remember, it is two channel.
Cool, well, that concludes this video. So if you wanna know a little bit more, I'm gonna be leaving you more information in the description because, as you know, documentation. We have some more videos coming out soon that we're already working on and already planning, so stay tuned for that. See ya.